Former Senator Antonio Trillanes IV gives Vice President Lenny Robredo a deadline to decide on her plans for the 2022 elections. Trillanes says he will be the one to run for president if Robredo fails to make a decision by 12 p.m. of October 8th, the last day of filing of candidacies. This as he vowed not to let the opposition lose by default. As of Sunday, Robredo has yet to bear her plans for next year's polls. She said on her radio show that she's still committed to uniting the opposition under one presidential candidate.
Siguro, merong iba na hindi na natin maaaya. Pero hanggang may communication lines pang bukas, patuloy ko yun ipopursue. 2022, ang daming nakakatakot na senaryo na pwede mangyari. Number one na nakakatakot ng senaryo, makabalik yung mga Marcos. Anong pangalawang nakakatakot na senaryo? Yung nangyayari ngayon, patuloy pang mangyayari in 6 years. Hindi na nga forgivable yung corruption at any stage. Lalo pa ngayong pandemic. So, pag nanonood ako ka Ellie, ang isip ko lang, paano kayo nakakatulog sa gabi yung mga taong ito? Na ang daming Pilipino naghihirap, yung inisip pa nila yung dilihensya.
Opposition Coalition Isambayan has also yet to decide on a presidential candidate to endorse in 2022. It says it's still in talks with Robredo, Trillanes, Manila Mayor Francisco Isko Moreno Dumagoso, and Senator Manny Pacquiao.
Senator Manny Pacquiao gets a second nomination to run for president in the 2022 national elections, this time from the Probinsya Muna Development Initiative Party, or PROMDI. PROMDI believes that Pacquiao, who hails from General Santos in Mindanao, represents the dreams and aspirations of those living in the provinces. The Philippines' fighting senator accepted the party's nomination during a ceremony held in Cebu, bailiwick of party founder and former Cebu Governor Lito Osmeña. Pacquiao is currently with the ruling PDP Laban, which has been split into two groups. The other wing, led by Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi, has nominated Senator Bongo to run for president and President Rodrigo Duterte for the vice presidential post. The Senate has lost contact with formerly pharmaceutical executive Crizel Grace Mago. That's according to Blue Ribbon Committee Chairman Richard Gordon, 2 days after Mago's damning testimony in the Senate panel's probe into the Philippine government's pandemic spending. Mago, formerly's head of regulatory affairs, said last Friday that she believed the firm had swindled the government in its multi-billion peso contract for face shields and face masks. She confirmed a witness's testimony that the company replaced its expiration dates and sold them as brand new.
You were swindling the government.
I believe so, Mr. Chairman.
The truth is, I was appointed. I was, how do I say this? I was, nilagay ako dyan for convenience, Mr. Chairman.
So, ginagamit ka nila?
And if you...
yes or no? Sa tingin mo, ginagamit ka lang nila yung pangalan mo?
For convenience, Mr. Chairman, I believe so.
The Senate offered to provide protective custody for Mago after Friday's hearing, but she said she needed time to think about the offer. Senators are now expressing concern for the well-being of the formerly official.
Marami nga po ang nagre-reach out sa kanya dahil concerned kami sa kanyang well-being, dahil parang siya ay naging or maaring maging whistleblower, di ba? Dahil inamin niya yung binunyag ng aming witness. Habang nadadagdagan yung aming ebidensya tungkol sa overprice at pag-award ng mga kontrata sa hindi karapat-dapat na kumpanya, ay maaaring madagdagan pa yung aming rekomendasyon tungkol sa mga kasong kriminal at administrative na pwedeng ihain.
The Presidential Security Group denies giving special treatment to Michael Yang, President Rodrigo Duterte's former economic advisor, who is being linked to the supposedly anomalous family deal. PSG Commander Colonel Randolph Kabangbang said no officer has been assigned to secure Yang. In one of the hearings at the Senate, an official of the firm said Yang helped them source funds for the government deal. The Justice Department has already released an immigration lookout order for Yang, who is believed to be staying in Davao City.